Hi everyone, welcome to my channel and you are listening to Subhash Chandran. In this video, we are going to cover the dimensional standards for pipes and pipe fittings, and this is going to be part 1 video. In part 2 and part 3 video, I will cover the standards for flanges and valves. So without wasting time, let's get into the video. And before going into the video, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please do give me a subscription to encourage me. So let's get into the slides. Dimensional standards are completely different for pipes and pipe fittings. We can't use the dimensional standards of pipes for pipe fittings. And further in pipes, you have two more classifications, carbon steel pipes and stainless steel pipes. Both have different standards. And likewise in fittings also, you have different types, which is butt well and socket and screw type. Both have different types of standards. So let's start with pipes. In pipes, the first type of pipe we have is the carbon steel pipe. The dimension details of the carbon steel pipes you will get from ASME B36.10M, and the description says welded and seamless wrought steel pipe. This is the cover page of the standard, and these are the informations you will get from this standard. In the standard, you have to go to the table 1. In table 1, you have two unit systems. One is imperial unit system, which is based on inches, and another one is metric unit system, which is based on mm. For most Indians, metric standards are convenient because and we are used for metric standards. So what are the informations you will get from this standard, this table? You will get the size of the pipe, and you will get the OD of the pipe, and you will also get the wall thickness of the pipe, and you will come to know the weight of the pipe per foot. And where in metric standard, the same values you will get in terms of mm and weight in terms of kg per meter. And moreover, you will get the details of thickness, different types of thickness available for a particular pipe. Say for an example, you have 10, 30, 40 and 80. These are schedule numbers, and each schedule numbers will have a different thickness. And you also have a standard and extra standard. So the description of standard and X, single X and double XS, you will get the over here actually. So this much of informations you will get from this particular standard. Now let's go to the other one, which is stainless steel pipes. Stainless steel pipe dimensional details, you will get it from ASME B36.19M, which is stainless steel pipes, and this is how the cover page looks like actually. And similar to the carbon steel, you will also get all these details from stainless steel table 1. So if you go to the standard, go to table 1, you will get all these details. You will get the size of the line, OD, wall thickness and weight actually. And likewise, like in carbon steel standards, you will also have this in both units, imperial units and as well as in the metric units actually. Now let's go to the pipe fittings. In pipe fittings, the first classification we have here is the butt well fittings. Butt well fittings, you will get the dimensional details of butt well fittings, you will get it from ASME B16.9, and the description says factory made wrought butt welding fittings. This is how it looks. This is the cover page of this particular standard. So what are the information that you will get? You will get all this information, such as say for an example, for elbow, you will get the size of the elbow. So the size of the elbow predominantly sized with the A dimension. And for 45, it gives you the dimensions for 90 and as well as for 45. You will get these dimensions for all the sizes. So likewise, you will get for short radius elbow, you will get for T's, and you will get for the cross, and also you will get for reducers. So I would request you to just visit the standard so that you will come to know what all the other components you will get it actually. So this particular standard will exactly give you the end-to-end dimensions of each and every butt well fittings basically. And now we will go to the another type, which is the screwed and socket fittings. See, screwed and socket fittings both are put into one standard, which is ASME B16.11. And the description says like this: forged fittings, socket welding and threaded fittings. So you can understand this from here clearly. Forged fittings and socket welding and threaded all are put in one particular standard. So what are the informations that you will get actually? So this is how the cover page looks like. ASME B16.11, forged fittings, socket welding and threading. Like in other previous standard that we have seen, and you will also get all these informations for in this particular standard also. And let's see what are the components that it is covered in this particular standard. It also covers 90 degree and cross, and the T connections, 45 degree elbows, coupling, half coupling cap, and threaded components, even threaded elbow, threaded tees, threaded cross. You will get all the informations of these particular components in the standard. You can see the dimensions marked over here. I did not capture the table over here because that was huge actually. So if you can go to the standard, these standards are very simple to understand, very easy to understand. You just have to go to the dimensional tables. There will be a table 1, 2, 3, 4, and you can refer whichever you will have this picture over here with respective picture and respective table. You just have to get this dimensions actually. So this is the importance of dimensional standard, because most piping design engineers do not know anything about it. Where do they get the dimension for this components? Because personally, in most companies are using some tools to generate these dimensions, in terms of either it could be an Excel made tools or it could be a programmed tool. But it is always good to know about the basic standards and where do you get this information, because this is the root for piping design. The standard also covers more number of fittings, and you can just go and verify this so that you will get an idea about it. I believe that this video helped you to understand the dimensional standards for pipes and pipe fittings. Study the standard so that you will come to know what exactly the standard says. Thanks for watching my video and thanks for supporting me. If you like this video, please do give me a like, because this will indicate that you like these types of contents. And also don't forget to share with your friends and who are into piping engineering. And one more request, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, because that gives me an encouragement and motivation to do more and more videos. I'll meet you in another fantastic video. Until then, bye from Subhash Chandran.